ngày mà anh thơ
bà
nâng nâng việc bóng sạch máu mới nhưng ớt đơn thơ ấy kì việc sạch việc bóng chanh mọc nóng lắm mới.
Ok. Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
It is correct, ma'am. Today, we come and then they do the operation and have ammonia. And also, I agree with that.
Okay, so initials is what she's writing. Then I'll have her sign in three different places.
Okay, so I think you'll have to make hand of me.
Signing her name, but it was just initials that I needed. But that's okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Her signature is what she's signing to actually give Dr. Rawson permission to do the procedure. With the understanding that he explained to her what he'd be doing, she knows what she's having done and why she's having it done and the benefits of having the surgery, and that Dr. Rawson also talked to her about risks that can be involved with the surgery, and she's ready to proceed.
Finishing
signing her name. And then we'll move on to the next one. Not allergic to any medication. Okay, next page. Okay. Next page, identification of persons performing significant surgical tasks to let her know about anesthesia's involvement. Our anesthesia is provided through a group called Team Health. It will be an anesthesiologist working with a certified nurse anesthetist to take care of that. Signing on the next page is to say I've made her aware of their participation in her case. And she is not allergic to any medication or foods that she's aware of? Okay. Last page she has to sign is consent to a blood transfusion. It is not typical for this procedure, but we ask everybody going to surgery in case of an emergency. So what I need to know is if there was an emergency where the doctors felt it necessary to give her a blood or a transfusion of blood products, if she's okay with that, then she can sign on the line. Does she handle her own medications, or did you
got
a
meeting
about
that? Okay. So you know the name of the person from when she last took everything? Your son helped you with the medicine?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, I just need to know, when was the last time she had anything to eat or drink?
Yeah.
Okay.
What's that?
No drink, no eat.
Since what time?
Six.
Six yesterday evening?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, is she okay with her son helping me with her medicines? Okay, so a few quick questions. Does she smoke or has she ever? Drink alcoholic beverages?
No.
Use any recreational or street drugs now or in the past? Okay, and does she feel safe at home? She lives with you?
Yes.
Okay. Never purposely tried to hurt herself? And when she's given instructions, how does she feel she remembers information best? Does she do better seeing and reading information, hearing or being told, or is she better hands-on? Which one works best for her to remember information? A few things I need her to know are that for her safety, everybody should be asking for her to verify her name and her birth date and checking her armband before we do anything with her, any type of procedure, giving her medicine, those types of things. Also, she should see that we're washing our hands before we start touching her, either with soap and water or using the antibacterial scrub. And if not, we encourage her to speak up and stop us and remind us to do that. And it's for her safety that she should have us do that, okay?
Okay.
Okay. And 0 to 10 is the pain scale that we use. 0 being no pain, 10 the worst pain, everything else in between. Is she having any pain right now? Right now? And where does it hurt? And 0 to 10, at what number would she say, okay, I'm not comfortable with this pain anymore, let me take something or do something to relieve it? Okay, no metals inside her body from previous surgeries, accidents, other procedures. Anything removable from her mouth, like partials or dentures? Has she fallen in the last 6 months? Has she had any falls in the last 6 months? Okay. No open sores or wounds on her body? Okay, well, thank you very much. We'll have her son help me with her medications, and I appreciate it. What was your ID number again?
Okay, 06278.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.